The one constant through all the years, Ray, has been baseball. America has rolled by like an army of steamrollers. It's been erased like a blackboard. It's a part of our past, Ray.
This is all related to time travel, by the way.
I mean, I can picture it, this dark, cavernous...
Do snails count? Hi, welcome to Comedy Parenting Radio. My name is Jerry Bagley, and this is the show that signs all of its cast members up for advanced rubber band stretching classes.
They're actually pretty useful. Yeah.
And the schedule is pretty flexible as well.
Oh, my goodness. Coming out of the gate there, Joshua. Nicely done. Today, we're going to be talking about unusual things to be afraid of. We all know what you're supposed to be afraid of. This list is a little bit different. Stay tuned.
Ranger Station.
Hi, I want to report a bear sighting.
Location?
My front door. It was Smokey Bear. My husband was burning leaves in the yard. He just came inside for a second.
Never leave a fire unattended. If it's too hot to touch, it's too hot to leave.
Smokey said that too.
We go way back. I knew him when he was just a cub.
How cute.
If you see someone in danger of starting a wildfire, step in and make a difference. Brought to you by Smokey Bear, the U.S. Forest Service, your state forester, and the Ad Council. Learn more at SmokeyBear.com.
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Talk, Johnson, or we're gonna make you listen to Comedy Parenting Radio.
No, I'll talk. I'll tell you everything.
You're back with Comedy Parenting Radio, unusual things to be afraid of, and I'm going to kick this one off, gang.
I'm afraid of being kicked.
Oh, man, I always knew that you were afraid of soccer.
Napkins.
What?
Napkins. I'm not afraid of napkins. You guys are afraid. All of you guys are afraid of napkins.
Why are we afraid of napkins?
Every time it's time to set the table for dinner... I put napkins around everybody's plates. You guys, on the other hand, no napkins. Zero napkinos, okay?
I mean, have you ever taken the journey to the napkin bin?
Well, you got to get on your knees for one thing.
It's a dangerous one.
But I think you guys are afraid to even touch napkins. I, on the other hand, am not, am I?
You are the exact polar opposite. You have a fear of not using enough napkins.
Absolutely.
Dad goes through one tree's worth of napkins every single time we have a dinner. Please donate $5 so that we can save a tree for every single napkin Dad uses.
Well, it's not that Dad just loves using napkins. It's just that he's so messy.
I'll have a stack of napkins next to me at the meal. And you guys don't even... You guys will wipe your mouths on your sleeves on anything else other than a napkin. Can't touch a napkin.
You know, I think that learning to lick your lips would about halve your napkin consumption.
Also, the other thing is, I do not eat like you. I am not that messy.
You know, they say it's not unusual to be in love with anyone, but I think it's pretty unusual that I am afraid of love.
Okay, tell us about your fear of love.
Because one day when I was young, I fell into a vat of chocolate at a chocolate heart-making factory, and ever since then I've been afraid of love.
Or at least Valentine's Day.
I don't think you get the concept of love.
I do get love of chocolate, but other than that, no.
And the way to a man's stomach is through chocolate love.
Love is the thing that rushes through your heart. Love is the thing that hits you when you see something nice. Love is the thing that is very nice to have in life. Hey, where are you guys going?
It's blood. Everything he just described there could be blood.
Okay. All right. Something else that's unusual to be afraid of.
You know, I've heard that there's a fear of ovens.
Why would you be afraid of an oven?
Someone does a patty cake, and shove you into an oven.
Well, I mean, some people, like, they never bake anything. So they must be afraid of the oven, right? I mean, I could picture it, this dark, cavernous, warm thing with metal teeth-looking things in it. I could totally see somebody being afraid of that.
I'm not really afraid of the oven. It's like taking it out of the hot oven with my bare hands as hurts.
That's, yeah, okay.
Well, no wonder. That's because your cooking goes so hot, we don't even have any mittens because it melts through them.
That stuff will be killing you.
Unoven bread. Unleavened bread. Unleavened bread.
I could see that some people might be afraid of ovens.
You are not very good at wry humor, are you?
By the way, what kind of a get-together of different breads do you not want to be around?
What?
Riots.
You know, there's one thing I've always been afraid of. Recording these shows.
Why would that be?
Well, we're great fun.
First off, I am so scared that the thing I may have made, the best joke that I make, may not get on the show. And I'm also scared because this microphone is too tall, and I'm afraid that if I stand on my tiptoes much longer, my toes will break off and I'll fall over.
You could just move to a different microphone.
I mean, here on the
They're
show...
They're adjustable.
Or you could just grow taller, scrub.
I mean, when you're here recording at the studio, if you say anything that's unfunny, you get put in the under basement for a few days.
That'll teach him to be not funny.
Boy, howdy. And that is the exact reason why I do not like recording these shows and why it scares me.
Is everybody wearing their funny buttons tonight so that we're funny?
Yes, and yep. Our funny hats.
I'm wearing funny glasses.
We had some pretty funny food on the way in. My stomach's still feeling funny.
Stop stealing my jokes, you guys. Say all these jokes.
I was about to say that joke. I'm like, it was clown food for dinner. Tasted funny. The power of the editor will come through on the show.
For thieving of jokes.
The cool thing is these guys can make a joke on the air, and then after they leave, when I'm editing, I can say the joke and put it on the air. Sounds like my joke.
For all you guys know, he's never made an original joke in his life.
They've all come from us.
That's not true. What else was an unusual thing to be afraid of?
Tables.
I'm afraid of duplicity.
Are you afraid of tables?
Kind of.
Why?
Because some tables are super tall, and then I have the short chair, and then I'm afraid that if I get up and out of my chair, I'm going to bonk my head on the table, and it's not going to be fun.
What are you, a hobbit?
Plus, sometimes everything is going your way, and suddenly the tables are turned on you.
This is an actual fear that people have, so we need to be serious about this, guys. Deep water. Not deep water, but any water that people can't see the bottom of. It could be 3 feet deep. As long as you can't see the bottom, if it's murky, some people are so scared they will not go into that water.
If I can't see the bottom of it, I'm afraid of chocolate milk.
I mean, yeah. Have you ever been to a swamp? It's such the weirdest feeling when you're just walking through this, like, knee to waist high deep water, and your feet are just sinking, and you don't know whether your next step you're just gonna go down and down and down and never know when you'll stop.
Either that, or it's the fear that some giant sea creature will come out that rationally you know will not come out of something that is that shallow, but your brain knows that the sea monster is gonna come out of that water.
You know those freshwater megalodons.
Hey, Courtney, this wouldn't happen to be because you recently waded across a river holding your backpack above your head while you were in chest-deep water?
No, this couldn't possibly be because of that.
So, even though you're about 1,200 miles from the ocean, you're worried about sea creatures coming up from the deep and chomping you?
Maybe.
Well, this isn't completely really related, but I thought of something. When a biker is waving to you, it's literally, and they're going down like something like our road, it's literally a matter of life and death if they wave to you.
For you or them?
For the biker. If you're driving in a car and a biker's coming towards you, okay, on a really bumpy road, it is literally a matter of life and death if they wave to you.
That's why you never wave to other people when you're on a bike on a bumpy road.
I give the 15-year-old freshman head nod.
I just thought you were grumpy.
That kid didn't wave to me for the third time this week.
I think you just need to learn to control your bike with one arm.
I can, but when you're going down something that literally gives you instant arthritis.
Or just do the victory sign from World War II.
Yeah, I don't think people understand how bumpy our road is. They're picturing a concrete or black
It could dismantle a tank.
To put it in perspective, after a 8-minute ride down our road, it takes about half an hour to pick up all the parts that I left behind.
Truthfully, I broke the springs on our 1-ton van on our road.
And I lost my seat and my front brake to it.
I've seen cars over the edge. We've had a muffler break off, cracked windshields.
And the worst yet, the mud. Oh, so much mud.
All the trim inside of our vehicle is like shutters, more less. Less like trim and more like shutters. Just kind of hinges there.
And the worst part of our road is at the very bottom, just before you get to the row of mailboxes.
Mm-hmm.
You have to jump over a moat.
Yep.
Filled with alligators.
From Solar Brian's on down is the worst part of the road. By the end, I can't even, like, move my fingers yet.
Comedy Parenting Radio, unusual things to be afraid of. Get your blankies. We'll be right back. I should probably warn you, I'll be just fine. No offense to you, don't waste your time.
Are you tired of the same old music at your parties?
Do your guests leave early because of the same old, same old?
Well, get ready for something new, exciting, and fresh.
Hawaiian Banjo Songs.
That's right, Hawaiian Banjo Songs.
We've put together the most amazing collection of all time Hawaiian banjo music that will
blow you away.
Listen to songs like Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Mele Kalikimaka.
And this song that we didn't know the name of.
With Hawaiian Banjo Songs, you get 139 songs on a 13-CD set. That's over 500 hours of music for only $5.95. That's right, $5.95.
This set normally sells for $6.95, but it's yours if you act now.
Order your box of Hawaiian Banjo Songs now.
Operators are standing around board.
Hawaiian Banjo Songs is not sold in stores. The owner of Hawaiian Banjo Songs cannot be contacted in the continental United States. Listening to Hawaiian Banjo Songs may have side effects. These include nausea, vomiting, and loss of friends on social media. Hawaiian Banjo Songs does not accept returns. Void where prohibited.
You're listening to Comedy Parenting Radio.
Welcome back to Comedy Parenting Radio. We are hiding under the table and eating sandwiches.
Can you pass me that mayonnaise?
I'm afraid of butterflies.
What? They're so pretty. How could you be afraid of butterflies?
Have you ever had butterfly kisses?
Haven't you ever heard of the butterfly effect?
Yeah.
I haven't.
I don't like hurricanes, that's for sure.
Tell me about the butterfly effect.
Well, the butterfly effect basically means that the smallest detail, like, I don't know, you stepping on a grub worm will change, will prevent a volcano or make a volcano
happen. This is all related
happen.
To time travel, by the way.
Grub worms? Volcanoes? Time travel? I'm in. Let's do it.
I'm afraid of deep subjects.
What do the butterflies have to do with this?
The saying is that a butterfly flapping its wings on one side of the world will cause a hurricane on the other.
Is that true, Josiah?
Eventually, farther down the timeline, the smallest thing that you affect will grow larger and larger and larger until it grows astronomical.
Scientifically, no, because the law of conservation of matter and energy completely negates that, but...
I'm with Elijah, and I think we should just stay home and watch Netflix.
You don't even watch Netflix.
You don't even have a Netflix account.
Yeah, but if a butterfly is going to wreck the world, I'm all for staying home.
No, we're going to go watch Netflix. We're going to watch all the people catch all the butterflies.
Ooh,
so we can't.
Yeah, butterfly catching movies are Netflix.
So that we can prevent the butterfly effect.
See?
Although we are not doing anything.
Nothing like Elijah saving my bad joke.
I think we could do one more.
I have to admit, gentlemen.
I have to admit, I'm afraid of butterflies.
There's a lady in the presence.
Along that same vein, I have to admit that I am afraid of little baby animals.
Little baby animals?
why would you ever be afraid of little baby animals? They're harmless.
Have you ever seen a little baby turtle or a little baby rabbit?
Why are you afraid of little baby animals?
Because it feels like if you just look at them or touch them, you're gonna hurt them in some way.
Wouldn't they be afraid of you?
That's exactly it.
He's afraid that they're afraid of him, and that's why he's afraid.
I'm afraid that you that
he's
I'm
afraid
hurt.
That they're afraid that he'll hurt them. That's why he's afraid.
I'm afraid not.
I'm afraid you've confused me.
Do snails count?
They can count, but they're really slow.
What?
Everybody's stealing everybody's jokes tonight.
We're all in the, you guys are all on the same wavelength, and it's not a very big one either.
No, joke stealing 101. Telepathic mind reading.
More like telepathetic.
And though we're loath to always mention it, we're coming up to the grand finale of the show.
Which might or might not be the most grand thing that we have said all night.
Usually when I say that, it's means we don't have something to say, except for it always causes someone to think of something genius at the end of the show, really pull it out of the hat. So you guys take off your hats.
I'm afraid of hats.
You've been listening to Comedy Parenting Radio, Unusual Things to Be Afraid Of. Thank you guys for coming into the studio today.
You're welcome.
I'm afraid it's time to go, y'all. It's been fun.
And before you guys go,
yes.
Yeah.
Make sure that when you leave the studio that you're all holding hands too, okay?
Yeah.
And why might that be?
Because you're afraid?
I'm afraid of hand-holding.
Bye-bye.
I'd say that was a pretty successful broadcast.